Congo is that they're chestnut brown color, and they have about a dozen or so vertical body stripes. They have several cheek spots on their cheek, and then there's a bright chevron shape on their forehead. And they also have some stripes on their legs as well, and all these different markings help them blend into the forest where they live. And as you can see, they have horns. Both sexes, male and female, have horns. And you can tell the males are much broader and wider than the females. And the females are a little bit skinnier, but they're a little longer. But they're situated closer together. And with the bongos, their horns also have 1 to 1.5 twists. And so that's another characteristic that's unique to bongo. The bongos use their horns for several things. They can use it to not only put their head in the mud, sometimes you can see them scratching around to just scratch that area on their head, but they can also use them to dig up roots that they find in the wild to help them find more food. Sometimes bongos do spar with their horns. Males usually will spar for rights for females, but it's not with the speed or intensity of, say, bighorn rams do, but they will spar somewhat. And once in a while, you will see the females spar a little bit, but it's more play or something to do rather than actual fighting or for aggression. Bongos can be found coast to coast in Central Africa. There's two different types of bongo. There's the western or lowland bongo, and then there's the eastern or mountain bongo. We have the eastern here, and they're a little bit larger, but they're one of the largest forest-dwelling antelopes for their size. And males are typically around 600 or 700 pounds, and the females are usually 500 or 600 pounds. Here at the Virginia Zoo, we've had lots of success breeding bongo, which is very important because their numbers are dwindling out in the wild. Over the last couple years, with the last male we've had 9 babies be born. We're also looking into getting a new male and hoping to get more babies here. But something that's very important that we were involved in 2004 is one of our babies from Essie, our oldest female here, actually was part of the Kenyan repatriation program to help get bongos back into the wild, to help get their numbers back up. We try to do different enrichment activities for the bongo every day, and that's just to make their lives more exciting and to keep their brains thinking all the time and try to bring out natural behaviors. So we'll put their food in different locations of the yard, and we'll also try to present browse to them in different ways that make that just a little bit more difficult and more natural for them to be able to get those leaves off instead of just handing them their food every day. We'll also have different toys, different shaped items that have holes in them. We'll put produce or some sort of treat inside so they have to figure out a way to get that food out to be able to eat it. So we'll try to give the bongo something new every day to keep their senses active and keep them from getting bored being in the yard all the time. Something else that they really enjoy is putting something in the yard that has another animal scent on it, so they also get to kind of visit different items that they wouldn't normally find in their yard. So that just helps keep things natural for them to be smelling new things, kind of meeting other animals just through scented objects or even fecal piles from something else. That's something that they'd normally come across in the wild, but here in the zoo setting, they wouldn't really get to do that. So we just try to keep things as natural as we can and just keep as many of their natural behaviors active as we can. So we have 3 adult females in our exhibit. The oldest one is Essie, and then her 2 daughters, Betty and Junie. And you can tell them apart because Essie has the longest horns, and they're also just a little bit different lengths. One's longer than the other one. She also has 3 cheek spots, and then Betty, the older daughter, has pink on her nose. She also has 3 cheek spots, and her horns are symmetrical. And then Junie, the youngest, her horns are spiraling almost that they're going to be crossing, and she just has 1 cheek spot. So that's the main differences that help tell us apart from each other, but they do also have different personalities. Essie, I would say, of our herd is the most dominant. If there's anything that's scary or new, she's kind of the protector of the herd. She also gets first dibs on any food items or any treats that come in the yard. Usually when we put toys or something fun out in the yard, Essie will see it first, but if she's not interested, then Junie's the most curious. She'll kind of check things out for the longest amount of time. And Betty's just a little more standoffish and skittish with people and new objects and new animals. So that's just some different personality differences of the 3 bongo that we have. Bongos are one of my favorite animals to work with. I really love this type of antelope, and that's just because their colors are so striking, and they're one of the more calm type of animals, so we can work with training with them, work in close proximity, and they're just really great to work with. So if you ever come to the Virginia Zoo, make sure you make time to come and check them out.